major U.S. contractors are in here like gangbusters. They are trying very hard. I think there is an the 15 companies that are shortlisted for the first phase of the Doha Metro. They're all joint ventures. I'd say 8 or 9 of them have major American companies involved. Again, our problem is that there's a lot of very good American subcontractors, specialists, people who do particular kinds of contracting work, and getting them to come here and actually spend the 6 months to a year that it takes to get you into the market is like pulling teeth. Unfortunately, most American smaller companies, even the larger companies, in fact, tend to treat each enterprise as a separate profit or revenue source. So I talk to them and I tell them, we need you to, you need to come out here, you need to put somebody here, and he needs to sit here for 6 months. It's going to cost you $500,000 to do that. The answer is, well, we can do that when we get a contract, to which my answer is, if you don't put them out here, you're not going to get the contract. So this I think is the single biggest obstacle, is the mindset that I have to offset the money that I'm spending. My argument to them is, don't treat it as a business expense, treat it like you do advertising and legal fees. But with the smaller companies in particular, it's been a drag. It's been very difficult to get them to come out here. The other area where things have changed only recently has been Qatari reluctance to invest in the United States, large-scale investment. There's been a lot of small-scale people buying homes and stuff like that. But other than the investment in the Golden Pass LNG facility, Sabine, Texas, which was $15 billion, I think, dollars, the next major Qatari investment, the direct Qatari investment in the United States, has been the $700 million investment in City Center in Washington, D.C. And it's been a long time getting the Qataris to go. There have been a lot of reasons for it. One is, I think the Qataris are simply much more conservative investors in many ways than some of their brethren in the Gulf. And secondly is, we are far away. We are distant. It's the flip of the problems we have with small, medium-sized companies. We have exceedingly complex laws and tax regimes and stuff like that. And it's but I'm optimistic. I think that one's going in the right direction. One issue that I don't think is fully understood in the United States has been the Qatari commitment to perhaps democratization, certainly the liberalization of the Arab world. I don't think it's an exaggeration to say that Al Jazeera was, not the primal cause, but certainly an important cause of what happened in Tunisia and what happened in Egypt. And there certainly is a very considerable Qatari commitment to the modernization, the political and social modernization of the region. I think the Qataris see it in a very pragmatic way, is you either move forward, you either advance democracy, you advance participatory government in the region, you advance the participation of Arab citizens in their countries, which will be a source of stability, a source of prosperity, and everybody's better off in the future, or you sit on it and it blows up. So I think I don't think Qatar's role in pushing this, say, in Libya and Syria and elsewhere, has been fully understood and appreciated in the United States. And next month, we hope to put together a trade mission to come out here to be part of the exhibition here in Qatar, aimed again at small to medium-sized enterprises. We're making a special effort to recruit new companies into the council games related, World Cup related projects. For example, in alternative energy, special ways of people who are involved in stadiums, people in transportation, in rail. So we're basically, that's where our recruiting effort right now in the council is. We are going to be working on trying to get a trade mission out that's regionally based out of Chicago, and that's on our schedule right now. It's still in the process of forming up. That would be in May. We have an excellent relationship with the UAE Council and the Saudi Council. We're non-competitive in a way. We're actually very complementary of each other's efforts. We have been working lately, for example, with the department, with the U.S. Trade Representative's office, in their efforts to revive some of the talks in the region on trade agreements between the GCC states. And frankly, those are the three countries that are drivers right now in the GCC, in the relationship with the United States.